In order to allow your employees to plan their leaves or vacation beforehand or in advance, you need to track the leave or vacation balance. Leave or Vacation Tracker is a software or tool which allows you to keep proper track of employees' leave on a regular basis. In today's video, we will see how we can track employee leave in Excel on daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly basis. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Mom. Let's start the video without any delays.
This is a leave tracker which I have already created in advance. Here are name of the months which will be managed by dropdowns. Again, the years will be managed by dropdowns. Once we will change the month, all the dates and days will automatically change along with highlights of Saturdays and Sundays. Even the dates and days will be highlighted once the month will end. Type of leaves will be selected through dropdowns. When we come in extreme right hand side, we see sum total of all type of leaves. Here I have got a column of total leaves which is connected with all leave types. When we come in extreme right hand side, we see leaves along with their codes. I have inserted codes over here also to avoid any type of confusion. Suppose you have taken 5 CL and 4 SL, it will show in total leaves, means total leaves got 9, in which 5 are CL and 4 are SL. In case your leaves will be more than 9, the total leaves will become red. For 12 months, we have got 12 sheets over here, from Jan to December. Apart from that, we have got two more sheets, annual leave tracker and top sheet. I have kept one more sheet over here, that is leave master blank sheet. In case you will have to create a new leave tracker, this can be used. Each and every sheet has got a clickable button on the top, which is linked or connected with top sheet. In top sheet, we have got various buttons to jump from one sheet to another. Let's start creating a new annual leave tracker now. We will open a new workbook and will type name of the tabs or worksheets which we want to insert. In first cell, we will type anything. I'll type ABC, leave master sheet blank, annual leave tracker, top sheet, and now we will type name of the months. We will drag this till December. Now we will click on the top, means on ABC, and we'll go in insert, pivot table. From here we will select new worksheet and we will do OK. We will come in extreme right hand side and we will click over here, means on ABC. We will drag this and we'll drop in our filters. We will go in home once again and we'll click on options. From here we will select show report filter pages and we'll click over it. We will do OK and all the tabs got renamed. We will close this. We will come in extreme right hand side. There are two extra sheets, so we will select this and we'll delete it. We will select these three, annual leave tracker, master blank sheet and top sheet. And we will take this in beginning. So all our tabs got renamed. We will press shift and we select all the tabs. We will go in view and we'll remove the grid lines. We will keep selected all the tabs and we'll remove pivot table link. We will click over here and we'll delete it. So grid lines got removed from all the tabs as well as link of pivot table got removed. Now I'll paste blank format over here to save our time. So this is my blank format. We will create dropdown for months over here. We will go in data, data validation. From here we will select list and we will type name of the months. We will do OK and our dropdown got created. Now we will change the font style. We will select this. We will go in home and we'll select impact from here. We will increase the font size. Over here, we will create dropdown for years. We will go in data, data validation, list, and over here we will type years. And we will do OK. Our dropdown for years got created. We will increase the size. Now we will insert formula for dates and the formula will be plus or equal to date value bracket open double inverted comma 1 double inverted comma close and we will select month and we will select year. We will close the bracket and we will do enter. So first date got inserted. For second date and rest of the dates the formula will be totally different and the formula will be plus or equal to if bracket open first date is smaller than EO month means end of the month bracket open first date comma 0 bracket close comma first date plus 1 comma double inverted comma twice and we will close the bracket and we will do enter. One thing more over here, we will have to lock the cells. So we will insert dollar over here means between F and 3 dollar. Over here also we will have to insert dollar function F4 and we will do enter. Now we will drag this. You might notice one thing. After 28th, it's showing blank. But we want EOM to be here, means end of the month. So we will be going in formula once again. And over here in the end, between two inverted comma, we will put EOM. And we will do enter. Now we will drag this once again. And in the month of Feb after 28th, it's showing EOM, means end of the month. We will change the month. And EOM got vanished. Now we will insert formula for days. And the formula will be plus or equal to text bracket open. We will select the date, comma, double inverted comma, DDD, double inverted comma, close, bracket close. And we will do enter. Now we will drag this till end. I'll change the month. Now we will highlight EOM. We will select this and we'll go in home, conditional formatting, new rule. From here, we will select classic, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And we will insert our formula over here. Plus or equal to, we will select the first day is equal to double inverted comma EOM, double inverted comma close. And we will remove the first dollar. We will click on the drop down and we'll go in custom format. Fill, and we will select red color over here. Okay. And EOM got highlighted. When we will change the month, the highlights got vanished. Now we will highlight our Saturdays and Sundays. We will select this once again. We will go in conditional formatting, new rule, classic, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And the formula will be same, plus or equal to, we will insert bracket. We will select this. Is equal to double inverted comma Saturday, double inverted comma close. We will remove first dollar from here, close the bracket, plus bracket open. We will select this, we'll remove dollar. Is equal to double inverted comma Sunday, double inverted comma close, bracket close. And we will select red color over here. We will do okay. And our Saturdays and Sundays got highlighted. When we will change the month, highlights also got changed. Now we will create drop-down for our leaves. We will select this. We'll go in data validation. From here, we will select list. Over here, we will type all the leave codes. CL, PL, SL, ML, HD, WH, H, WO, A, LWP. And we will do OK. So our drop-downs got created over here. We will delete this. Now we will insert formulas over here. The formula for total leaves will be plus or equal to count A, bracket open. We will select from first date to last date, bracket close, and we will do enter. We will drag this till end. We will insert something over here and we'll check how our formula is working. So all the leaves are getting calculated over here. Now we will insert formula for CL, and the formula will be plus or equal to count if, bracket open. We will select from first date till last date, comma, double inverted comma, CL, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, and we will do enter. And our CL is getting calculated over here. Formula for PL will be same, plus or equal to count if, bracket open. We will select from first date till last date, comma, double inverted comma, PL, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, and we will do enter. We will drag this till end. For rest of the leaves, formula will be same. So we will insert formula in all. So all the formulas got inserted. We will drag this till end. We will delete this. So our master sheet got created. Now we will create our annual leave tracker. We will copy our master sheet and we'll paste over here. Month and year is not required, so I'll drag this. So our month and year got deleted. Dates and days are not required, so I'll delete this. I'll remove all the formulas. I'll merge this so it will be in center. We will have to insert two columns over here. I'll drag this, casual leave allowed, and over here casual leave balance. I'll delete the codes from here. We will do this annual leave tracker. So blank format got created. Now we will create our top sheet, insert. We will insert a shape over here. We will double click on the shape and we will go in shape format. We will remove the outline. We will right click on the shape and we will go in format shape. We will click on the center and we will give it a shadow. We will click on the shape. We will right click the mouse, edit text. And over here we will type leave tracker. We will go in home and we will change font style. We will take this in center and in mid. We will change color of font. We will right click on the shape. We will go in format shape, text, and we will give a shadow to the text. Now we will increase size of the font. We will click on the shape and we will press control and we will drag it. Now we will resize it. We will delete the text and we'll type name of the month, Jan. We will click on the shape, we'll press control and we will drag it. We'll drag once again. We will select all three by pressing control and we will make a copy of this. We will make this bigger. We will select all by pressing control. We will go in shape format, arrange, align, align, middle. So all the shapes got aligned. Now we will press control once again and we will drag this. So this got created for 12 months. Now we will rename this. We will click over here, we'll press control and we'll drag this. We will make it bigger and we'll rename it Annual Leave Tracker. We will change the color by double clicking on the shape and we will be diverted to shape format. We will change the color. We will change the color of this also. We will change the font color. We will make it white. Over here also we will make it white. We will click over here, we'll press control and we'll drag it. And we'll rename it as Master Sheet. Now we will click on one shape and we'll copy this. Control C or Command C. We will come in our Master Sheet and we'll paste the button over here. We will resize it. We will decrease the font and we'll rename it as Top Sheet. Now we will copy this once again. We'll go in Annual Leave Tracker and we will paste it over here. We will come in our Master Sheet, we will click on the button of Top Sheet, we will right click the mouse, we will click on Hyperlink, we will go in this document and we will connect it or link it from Top Sheet. So Monthly Leave Tracker Master Sheet got connected with our Top Sheet. We will go in Annual Leave Tracker and we'll connect this also. Right click the mouse, Hyperlink, Top Sheet, OK. Now we will select our Master Sheet. Control C or Command C and we will paste in all the months. So all the months got connected with Top Sheet now. But Top Sheet is still not connected with the months. So we will connect our Top Sheet from months. We will click on the month of Jan, right click the mouse, hyperlink. From here we will select Jan. OK. In the same way we will connect all the buttons, right click the mouse, hyperlink, select Feb, hyperlink, March. And I'll connect all the buttons in the same way. So all the months got connected. Now I'll connect Annual Leave Tracker also with Top Sheet. And we'll connect Master Sheet also. So all the sheets got interconnected now. We will change the months from drop down. So all the sheets got renamed as well as connected with the Top Sheet. Now we will put formula in our Annual Leave Tracker. Total leaves plus or equal to. We will go in the month of Jan and we'll select total leaves over here. Plus, we will go in month of Feb, plus March, plus April, plus May, plus June, and we will connect all the months. And we will do enter. So total leaves got connected with all the months. Total CL, we will drag this and the formula will get connected. We had inserted two columns over here, so we can't drag this till end. We will leave these two columns blank and we'll go in total PL. In the same way as we had connected total leaves, we will connect PL with all the sheets of the month. Plus or equal to Jan PL plus Feb PL plus March PL and I'll connect till December. And we will do enter. We will drag this till end and till here. So all the formulas got connected. In many companies or organization, fixed number of days are allowed as CL. So I'll take a random figure over here, 24. I'll drag this till end. Casual leave balance will be plus or equal to allowed leave minus casual leave taken. Enter. And we will drag this till end. Now we will do conditional formatting for total leaves. We will select this. We'll go in home, conditional formatting, highlight cell rule, greater than. We will put 9 over here and we will go to custom format, fill, we will select red color. Okay. In case leave will be more than 9 days, it will be red automatically. So when leaves got 11, it got red. In 10 also, it's red. When it's 9, it's not getting red or not getting highlighted. I'll delete this. In case you want to highlight your leave codes, you can do it by going in conditional formatting. I'll do conditional formatting for few leaves for you. I'll select this. I'll be going in conditional formatting. Highlight cell rule equal to, I'll take CL over here. I'll click over here on the drop down, custom format, fill. I'll select a color. Font, I'll select white color from here. Okay. I'll take one more, conditional formatting. Highlight cell rules equal to, and I'll take PL over here. Click on the drop down, custom format, fill. I'll take this color this time. Font, I'll make it black or white. Choice is totally yours. I'll do okay. Now I'll click over here and I'll select CL. So our CL got highlighted. I'll click over here, PL, and our PL got highlighted. So in the same way, you can highlight all your leaves by going in conditional formatting. Your leave tracker is ready now to be used. In case you want to download this form, I'll provide the link in the description box.
I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.